अथयो वेदेदं मनवानीति स आत्मा मनोस्य दैवं चक्षुः स वायेशेतेन देवेन चक्षुषा मनसैतान् कामान् पश्यन् रमते य एते ब्रह्मलोके। ऑन दिस मंत्र देयर इज इन ब्रह्मसूत्र वन अधिकरणम कॉल्ड स्वभावाधिकरण 4, 4, 10 to 14 फाइव सूत्रस has been discussed. Because in mantra two things are there together. The first portion is related to the explanation which is going on. Yayeshu Akshini Purushah. That is being explained. It was said that Akshini is Upalakshana, indicative for all other things. And that is being added now with the mind here. Sa Athayo Veda Idam Manvaniti. स आत्मा मनोस्य दैवं चक्षुः मननाय मनः दैट शुड बी एडेड ओवर इन बिटवीन हियर स आत्मा मननाय मनः भाषकर विटल दो इट्स नॉट जस्ट लाइक बिफोर श्रवणाय श्रोत्रम घ्राणाय घ्राण सिमिलरली हियर अगंधाय घ्राणम सिमिलर हियर आल्सो मननाय मननम दैट शुड बी देन मनोस्य दैवं चक्षुः फ्रॉम हियर मनोस्य दैवं चक्षुः एक्चुअली इज एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ जक्षन किरण रममाण how this person being liberated can how this person who is liberated can experience then we said up to here was yeshakshini purusha vesti and now daivam chakshuhu mana this person who is liberated from this body from embodiment he becomes identified with the universal and therefore he is now associated with according to prarabdha karma with the mind of the universal soul the samashti samashti mana is called as daivam chakshu and vesti man is also daivam in one way bhaskara will explain it but with the regarding to the context we will take it samashti bhaskara tells sarveshwarena manasa सर्वेश्वर मनस बोथ स्टेटमेंट्स बी यूज्ड बाय भाष्य दैवम चक्षु देयर दिस आर टू डिविजन्स हियर स आत्मा मननाय मननम एडिंग टू दिस विद दिस द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ यशोक्षिणी पुरुष एंड्स कंक्लूड्स द स्टार्ट्स नाउ द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ जक्षन ग्रहण रम माण यानैर्वा स्त्रीविर्वा एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा फॉर दैट इज मनो अस्य दैवं चक्षु स वायश दैवेन चक्षुष मनसा एतान कामान पश्यन् रमते य एते ब्रह्मलोके दैट्स व्हाट टोल्ड वेरी क्लियर इट्स ऑल प्रारब्ध कर्म बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रारब्ध कर्म दिस बॉडी इज एग्जिस्टिंग एज एन अज्ञानी सीज All types of actions happening through this body. Taking bhiksha, wearing dress, taking snanam and all. That also, and it is the samashti level. It is the samashti, based on Bhaskara what he said before. That liberated soul, if there is a desire of these things, according to prarabdha karma, becomes identified with Indra, etc. Then he enjoys them. Not with this body. In which he has attained the Brahmagnanam had become Brahmagnani, not through this body. He is now with the universal because he is Brahman. In Brahman only this universe is there. In this whole universe, Indra and everything are there. And he can get attached to any of the upadhi, depending upon his prarabdha karma, and experience those things. That's the Bhaskara vikalp. It's not necessarily that he will. He may that or may not also.
But
it does not matter. Prarabdha karma is making that. Here also it will be told. Because the prarabdha karma, that person, due to the prarabdha, will be having these adjuncts until videha mukti. Only after videha mukti becomes Brahma.
But that's in regard to this upadhi. The upadhi
yes.
Which he has attained.
No, that's true. Because in this upadhi, he came due to prarabdha karma. No doubt. And this upadhi he was accepting as a kartrutva, bhoktrutva of this upadhi before Brahmavidya experienced by him. But as soon as it dispels the Brahmavidya, it is not necessary that Prarabdha Karma is going to restrict to this body only.
But Prarabdha Karma brought this body along.
It has brought this body, and what do you know about Prarabdha Karma later on, what it would be?
But that is related only to this
upo. No, not necessarily. That is why you see Prarabdha Karma, for example, of Nachiketa. He had got one body. His Prarabdha Karma made him to live this body over here only. It was here. And he went up there. How he went? That was a part of the Prarabdha Karma. That's why he came back to this body. After attaining that Upadesha and all, he became the king again. That's the story. So like that, Dasharatha also went to Sarvaloka, it's said. That means what? The Prarabdha Karma is like that. Rukmini's father went to Brahma and asked, who is the bride for this, for my daughter? Who is the person who is taking birth on this earth? And he said, Krishna is the person. For that he went from here. Is not a part of his Prarabdha? So, a non-Brahmajnani Prarabdha is seen like that. The Prarabdha Karma has given birth to this body, and at the same time, within that Prarabdha Karma, there might be some karma which may relate him after Brahmajnana with the universal body, with the Samashti. Why not?
He becomes one with the Samashti.
No.
Samashti is, and there is no difference between him and the Samashti, he is everything.
He is everything, that's right. There is no difference in Samashti, no difference in Vesti. You are coming to the point now automatically by yourself. Therefore, it is not depending on this body also then, according to the Prarabdha Karma.
The body continues, correct?
Vesti is also continuing, let it continue, but it is not related to the Vesti itself. Now, after the Brahma Vidya has been successful in him, in his heart, in that particular heart, then automatically he rises from that particular heart. And he is now both Vesti and Samashti, everything. Therefore, it is related to everything. But now it begins again when he is related to everything and he is everything. Sarvam eva atma sarvatu bhava. Sarva eva atma sarvatu bhava. When he is everything now, then where he is? He is nowhere. He is nowhere actually. He is everywhere. Or in everything. He is everything and he is in everything. Therefore it depends now upon the Prarabdha Karma left over to which he will particular adjunct he may get related, or he may not get related. He may get related sometimes with this body, he may get related sometimes with some other body, or with Indra, or with Samashti mind itself, it might be anything may happen.
But all his karmas will be destroyed, right?
No. Who said? Not the Prarabdha Karma. Many times has been already discussed very well. Prarabdha Karma does not get destroyed.
Prarabdha Karma only with this related
to
this.
No, that's wrong. That's your again misconception. This is not what Shastra says. Shastra say Prarabdha Karma is gave birth to this body. But Prarabdha Karma is not only that much which is going to be bhoga in this body. It's not like that. That's why I gave you the examples of Nachiketa, Dasharatha and Rukma and all those people. They went, this body being here, they went to somewhere else. Into those worlds, this body cannot go. Then with the Prarabdha Karma, which gave birth to this body, among those Prarabdha Karmas, there are certain karmas which let him go from here to there. That was a part of that. When it is with a non-Brahmajnani, how you can say that a Brahmajnani's Prarabdha Karma will be only restricted to this body? Why not in that such Prarabdha Karma also, which is going to let him to experience through Indra, or some other, or through the Samashti itself? Or not, neither this, nor Samashti, nor the universal. Both may be. Neither the individual, nor the universal. It depends upon the Prarabdha Karma. That Prarabdha Karma is not related anymore with only to this body, as in the case of all. And even your personal Prarabdha Karma, you see, we see in the Swapna, in the dream state, what is that? Even that is also a part of the Prarabdha. But in that Prarabdha, it is going on. Are related anyway to this body? No?
Body. Huh? You have your own body.
Swapna
body.
That's Swapna body here. That's not related to this body which is. And did the Prarabdha Karma give birth to this body or to that body?
Both.
You have to accept, is it not? Similarly, it is here also. For a Brahmagnani in the Brahmagnani Prabda, those bodies can accept as a dream body. Anything can happen within his prarabdha. You can't confine his prarabdha to a particular body and that to an individual body, never. Then sarvatma bhava is lost. Therefore, you want to say, this is an explanation. Anandagiri is told very clearly, you see. Yeshokshan ityadi, the last line of Anandagiri in this page. Where the mantra is, in the same page. See, the last line of Anandagiri. Yeshokshan ityadi vakyam prapanchitam. Up to satna and all. Then, samprati, now, satatri ityadi, phalavakyam prapanchayati. ప్రపంచితం ఇంద్రియాంతరేభ్యో మనసో వైలక్షణం దర్శతి మనోస్య దైవం చక్షురితి. గాట్ ఇట్ ఆనగిరి లాస్ట్ లైన్ ఇట్స్ వెరీ క్లియర్. యూ సీ ఫలవాక్యం ప్రపంచయితం టు ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ ఇలాబరేట్లీ ద స్టేట్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ ప్రజాపతి రిలేటెడ్ టు ద రిజల్ట్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ విద్య ఆఫ్ ద బ్రహ్మజ్ఞాని. ఇంద్రియాంతరేభ్యో మనసో వైలక్షణం. He wants to differentiate totally mind from all other organs. Of that particular Brahma especially. For that this statement has come. Manosya, Daivam, Chakshur, etc. etc. Now see the mantra, then you'll go into the Bhashan, it will be more clear. Adayo Veda Idam Manvani Idi. Then one who knows, let me think this. Saratma, he is the self. For his thinking, the instrument is, the organ is mind. Mananai, Mananai. That ends the explanation of Yeshokshini Purusha. Manosid Daivam Chakshaha. Because now the question is, how the liberated soul can get associated to this prarabdharma or whatever reason with different bodies in the whole with universal self. Getting out of this or not getting anymore associated with this individual soul. He's becoming associated with the universal body, not this individual body anymore. In being in that body, how, what is the things, what he has got to experience. Mystery, Birvarya, Anirva, etc. For that he says, Asya, of this liberated soul, Mano, Daivam Chaksho. Mind is divine eye. Sava Yesha, he who is such, then possessed of a divine eye, that means the universal mind. Now he is possessing the universal mind according to his prarabdha, and he has detached himself with the individual mind in this individual body. Savayesha, he who is such, yetena daivena chakshasha, manasa, through this divine eye, the mind, etan kaman pashyan ramate, enjoys these desirable things, which are yete brahmaloke, which are in the world of Brahman, seeing through, pashyan, through what? Daivena chakshasha manasa yetera, seeing through the divine eye, the mind, the universal mind. Bhashyam. Adayo veda idam manvani iti. Then one who knows, let me think this. Idam manvani iti. Manana vyaparam. The action of thinking. How is that too? Indriya asanspristam. Let me undertake only the action of mind which is not associated with any other external organs. Indriya asanspristam manvani iti veda. I will be thinking like that. He who knows so, sa atma, that knower of certain this particular action or the witness of this particular action is the self. Mananaya manaha. The mind is meant for thinking. Yo veda sa atma ityam sarvatra prayoga. To conclude this part, Bhasha is telling, Yo Veda Satma is then each and every particular organ statement. Related to, with regard to each and every organ, this statement has come again and again, Yo Veda Satma. Since the expression, Yo Veda Satma, he who knows, he is the self, has been used again and again everywhere, Sarvatra, Prayogad, Vedanam, Asa Swarupam Iti Avagamyate. Therefore, it should be understood. That knowing, that is the consciousness, is the nature of the self. Vedanam means consciousness, knowing, being the witness, is the nature of self. Asya means of the self. Vedanam swarupam iti avagamyate. Yatha, with an example is giving now illustration. Yatha, yaha, prasthat prakashayati sa adityo, yo dakshinato, yaha paschad, yaha uttarato, yaha urdham prakashayati sa adityo ityukte, prakashaswarupasa iti gamyate. Just like somebody says, ityukte, somebody saying so, what? That which lights in the front, in the eastern direction, is the sun. Yaha prasthat prakashayati, that which lights or illumines things in the front of you, that eastern direction, is the sun. Yo dakshinato, and that which illumines to the right or to the southern direction. Yo paschat, that to the west or the back. Yo uttarada, that which towards the north or to the left side. Yo urdham, to the upper, in the upper direction. Prakashayati, lights or illumines. Saditya, that is the sun. Ityukte, when somebody says so, what do you mean by that? What do you understand by that? You understand that it is so, the sun. Prakasha Sarupa is of the nature of light itself. Nature of illumining things is the actual nature of the Sarupam, the nature of sun. Darshanadi Kriya Nirvrityarthanihi Tu Chakshuradi Karanani. Therefore, similarly, here also with self, as it is told to each and every organ, sātma, 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 that means what? It is the nature of the self is witness or consciousness, to know. Then what is the purpose of these things? Because sun, without any instrument, is illumining things, isn't it? And where is self needs for mananaya, mananam, shravanaya, shravatram and all? Said yes. Darshanadi kriya nirvrityarthani chakshuradi karanani. Eyes, etc., are the instruments for the accomplishment of the actions like seeing, hearing, etc. And that too why? Idam chasya atma samarthya davagamyate. See, the example cannot be taken in its whole, in totality. Depending upon the thing in which context we are giving the example, only that much only should be taken. As the self is concerned, even it is self-luminous. It's more self-luminous than sun. But still, as and because it is embodied now, through ignorance, etc., it is in need of these organs to accomplish the actions. Whereas sun is not being embodied. Therefore, no instruments needed to him. That's the difference. Idam chasi atma samarthyadaya, and this fact is understood from the very nature of the self, the way it is working over here in this body. Atmanaha satta matreva jnana kartrutvam natu vyapratataya. That does not mean this atma, the self, is getting engaged or totally involved in different actions. Kartrittam does not come into his atma. Therefore he says, Atmanaha jnana kartrittam satta matra eva nato vyapratataya. The agentship of the self with regard to knowing, etc., etc., knowing, hearing, seeing, etc., all the actions, jnana kartrittam is one indicative. But you have to take all things, shravanam, maranam, everything, is due to its mere existence only, satta matreva, and not from it being totally engaged or getting involved in totally in any of the action. Yatha savito satta matreva prakashan kartuttam nato vyavratayati tadvat. It is just as the sun's being the agent of illumination by its mere presence. Savituhu sattamatreva. By the mere presence of the sun is treated to be prakashana kritiddham, the agent of illumination of all the things. Natu vyapratataya, but it does not get engaged or involved totally of himself into the action of illumining things. That similarly is with the self. Mano asya atmano daivam. Up to here only is the explanation of Yayesha Akshini Purusha. मनो अस्यात्मन दैवम अप्राकृतम इतरेन्द्रिय असाधारणम। वॉट इज वाइट दिस माइंड इज कॉल्ड चक्षु हियर नो चक्षु इन द वर्ल्ड इज नो वेल नोन एज आई बट हियर यू टू टेक चष्टे पश्यति अनेन इति चक्षु दिस डिविजन ऑफ चक्षु इन द प्रेजेंट कॉन्टेक्स्ट व्हेन यू आर यूजिंग दैट वर्ड फॉर माइंड ऑफ दिस सेल्फ अस्य आत्मनः मन द माइंड इज द डिवाइन दैवम चक्षु द डिवाइन आई व्हाई इज कॉल्ड इज डिवाइन बिकॉज अप्राकृतम इट इज सुपर नेचुरल इट इज नॉट प्राकृतम प्राकृतम इज ऑफ द इंडिविजुअल सॉल्स माइंड इज प्राकृतम एंड ऑफ दैट द हिरण्यगर्भ इट इज अप्राकृतम सुपर नेचुरल There's a Bhashya is knowing using these words to make you realize the mind we are taking here in this present context is not of the person or the individual, but it is of the universal of Hiranyagarbha. Aprakritam, indriyai rasadharanam. Not only it's aprakritam, but totally different from the outer organs, sectional organs. Chakshu, it is the eye. For that mind we are using the word eye. But in which meaning? Not its gross meaning well known, but chashti, pasyati, anena, iti chakshu. The word is derived in the sense that is the instrument through which one sees. That means it thinks about the past, the present and the future too. What he says, the one chakshu that we know, we are using that by pashyati anena, which is doing, should take the one to the individual chakshu. No. Why? The individual chakshu and all the other individual indriyas, organs, how are they? Vartamana kala vishyani chi indriyani. Ato adaivani tani. Whereas the organs of individual person remain engaged in grasping or accepting only those things which are in the present time. Therefore, they are all non-divine. Adayavanitani. That are only in the present time. Thus they are not divine. And this is how he says, Manastu. But this mind, which is called as I over here at present, how is this? Trikala Vishayo Palabdhi Karana. The mind that is spoken of in the present has got the capacity, is the organ for perceiving things of all the three times, trikala, the past, present and the future. And further, if it has no defects, mriti doshancha, sukshma, vyavahitadi sarvopalabdhi karana. Now you come. How you can take this eye now? Even though derivation seems to be fit for this eye also, but it cannot be applied over here. Because he says, when this special eye, the mind, the universal, when it is devoid of all defects, mridita dosha, what capacity will be there in then? It's a sukshma, vyavahita, adi sarvopalabdhi karanam bhavati. As divided of all, it is the organ for the persons of everything, even though it is subtle, distinct, distant, etc., etc. And all that can be perceived by this divine mind called I. Not only further he explains, Savai Muktaha, iti Daivam Chakshu Ichyate, okay? Hence it is called as the divine eye. Now it comes to that point. Savai Mukta, Surupapanno, Avidya Krita Dehendri Mano Vyukta. You see? He is separated from this individual mind. Dehendri mano vyukta and got attached to which? Sarvat bhavam apanna san esha vyomavad vishuddha sarveshwara mano upadhi sya. And now he has got the upadhi of sarveshwarasya mana iti sarveshwara mana. Who is that sarveshwara? Hiranyakarbha's mind is the upadhi of this person now. He is the limiting adjunct of this person, of the liberated person. Sa vai muktaha. Sa vai means indeed, he indeed, who is liberated. Who has attained his own nature, Swarupapanna. Who has attained his own nature is what? He has become a Brahmagnani. Therefore, avidyakrita dehi indriya manoviyuktaha. Very clear, Bhashya Yanna. Avidyakrita dehi indriya manoviyuktaha. That person who has become free from the body, from the organs, and this individual mind too, which was created by the individual ignorance, avidyakrita. That is not mayakrita. Bhashyam is very, very.
Maya is
Ishwara. Ishwara Upadhi. That's why not mayakrita mana is not nivrittam. Avidyakrita mana eva nivrittam bhavati. See, every word you have to give importance to Bhasham, then things will become clear. You just read this avidyakrita, you can't get it clear. Then he says what further? Now what he is at present? He is devoid of this body, organs, mind, etc. He is free from all these. Then what he is? Sarvat bhava mapanna. He is himself everything. He has attained himself as all. He has identified himself with all. That's called Sarvat Bhavapanna. He has attained identity with all. Being so, son, being such, esha, this liberated person, Vyomavad Vishuddha. This one who is pure like space. Sarveshwara Mano Upadhi. But still, until he is not Videha Mukta, he will be having the Upadhi of what now? Maybe the Upadhi of Sarveshwara Mana. Sarveshwarasya Mana Eva Upadhir Asya. Iti Sarveshwara Mana Upadhi. Having the mind of the God of all. Sarvasya Ishwara, Sarveshwara. Is Hiranyagarbha. The God of all. His mind is the limiting adjunct of this liberated soul now. Being accepting that son, Upadhi's son, being or having the limiting adjunct, which the mind of Hiranyagarbha, he, what is he doing now? Etena eva ishwarena manasa. You see the difference now. Before he said, not ishwarena manasa, sarveshwara manupadhi, that samasa. And he is doing different. So Ishwarena Manasa. Here, Manasa, the words, qualities we mentioned now Sarveshwara. Before it was Hiranyagarbha's mind. And now it's what Sarveshwara Manasa means? The mind possessing the quality to rule over everything. Sarvesham Ishtum Samartyam. Ishitum Samartyam. Iti Sarveshwaruttam. Tena Yuktam. Iti Sarveshwarena Manasa. Both are Trityant. Visheshana, Vishesha Bhava here. It is showing the capacity of the mind now. Before our mind, how it was? It was Sarveshwaramana, the individual mind. Avidyakrita it is. Therefore, it has not got the ability to rule over everything in this world. But now, this mind, the divine mind, the universal mind, which has been the adjunct of the liberated soul, that mind's capacities, which has capacity to rule over everything. Sarveshurena manasa, etan kaman. Savitri prakashavat nitya prayatatena darshanena pashyan ramate. Without getting involved again, you see, that's why being in the example over here. Savitri prakashanavat. He does not get involved in any action of moving and laughing and eating and drinking, women and vehicles, etc. He is not getting involved in that. He is just like sun only even at that time. Etan kaman. These desirable things. Darshanena pashyan ramate. Darshanena pashyan ramate. With the vision only, externally spread like the light of the sun. Nitya pratanena, pratatena, nitya pratatena, eternally spread actually. Pratatam is spreading. Nityam is eternally spread like the light of the sun. Nitya pratatena manasa. How is that mind? That individual mind is not in one particular place. It is eternally spread all over the world, all over the universe. Therefore, he is just like the sun's light, which is spread all over the world in all directions. Through that you may say, the sun is seeing us, the sun is listening us. But that does not, it does not come and sit and hear and listen. Through his light rays, he is spread all over, and through that only is doing everything and not doing everything else. It is the same with the liberated soul. Because he now, because of his prarabdha karma, avidya lesha is there, which is due to which he has become the his upadhi now, the adjunct is the universal mind. And that universal mind is not in one particular place or in one particular body, but it is spread all over eternally. Through that, therefore, through vision only, darshanena pashyan ramate. You see very careful Bhashyakara again. Darshanena pashyan ramate. That's through vision he sees and enjoys. He does not get involved. He is not getting engaged. But how that Arapa comes that Brahmagyan is enjoying with the woman?
As though.
You have to, as it were? You have to say so?
Because he is the Atma of all.
He is Atma of all and he is all himself.
Whoever enjoys this,
his enjoyment only. He is enjoying through all in one
that
way.
That is the only way.
That is the only
it's
way.
Not that he is
actually going to do it. Deva Pashara Bhina said, Natu Vya Pratataya. In some example also same thing. In him also same thing it will be. Therefore, for the finally finishing now, kan kaman iti vishinasti. Which are those desirable things which he enjoys? That is being stated, specified over here. Yayete brahmani loke iti brahma loke. Those which are in the world of the Brahman. This whole universe is the world of Brahman. How that too? Hiranya nidivad bahya vishaya asanga anritena. Asanga andritena apihitaha sankalpa matra labhyaha. That he need not go and do anything to attain them now. He is now that capacity, he can just have a result in the mind. He wishes, he desires, it is there with him. So he is himself everything and is there in all also. Therefore, he can attain anything any moment. Nothing is away from him and far from him. Nothing is different from him too. Therefore, he says, even though it is like Hiranya Nidhi Vad, Bhai Vishing Asangandrata Pitaha. Even though it is covered by falsehood, in the form of attachment, Asanga Andritena Apita, covered, Apita means covered by Andritena, falsehood. In which form? In the form of Asanga, attachment. To what? Bahya Vishaya, outer things, external things. Like a mine of gold, Hiranyanidhivad, covered by earth. Even though it is so, but for this person, how it is? Which are all attainable for him, sankalu matra labhyaha. Even though it is so for all other people, but for him, it is sankalpa labhyaha. So the sankalpa is due to prarthakarma, it takes place, and it is, he attains that.
This is the same as in Taittiriya, Sarvan, Kaman, Samashnu.
Samashnu, same thing, no difference. Wished out of things like a mine of gold covered by earth, etc. But still these are attainable through that liberated soul just by a desire or resolve. So now it's clear, all your doubts which you are putting before, it's clear. Therefore now he has, that's the prarakarma now. Before, even though prarakarma started this body, but the prarakarma, the end of the prarakarma is not with this body now, because he becomes universal. The prarakarma is in that way. To this much period, the prarakarma says, you will be attached to this body. After that, the rest of the prarakarma is going to make you attach you with the universal body. And in between also, you may come to this body particular, according to the prior karma, and to that also, whichever is possible. There's a Bhaskara before, three vikalpa. To Indra, or this body, or to none of the bodies. Depends everything purely on prior karma. तम वाये तम देव आत्मन उपासते तस्मात् तेषां सर्वे च लोका आत्ताः सर्वे च कामाः स सर्वाश्च लोकान् आप्नोति सर्वाश्च कामान् यस्तम् आत्मन् मनुविद्यो विजानाति इति ह प्रजापतिरुवाच प्रजापतिरुवाच तम वाये तम देव आत्मन उपासते ही हु इज सच द सेल्फ इज मेडिटेटेड अपॉन बाय ऑल द डेटीज बिगिनिंग फ्रॉम इंद्रा टू एवरी ऑल द 33 क्रोर डेटीज विच यू स्पीक ऑफ Tasmat therefore, tesham, sarvecha loka attaha, they have attained all the words as also sarvecha kamaha, all the desirable things. Similarly, sa sarvasha loka napnoti sarvasha kaman, yaha, he who, having known, yaha, tam atmanam anuvidya, he who, having known that atma through the instructions of the teacher and scriptures, etc., Vijanati has realized the self, also attains all the words and all the desirable things, just like Indra and other deities had attained. This is what Prajapati said. And after explaining the meaning of the what Prajapati is, because this is the explanation now. So Srivirva Yanirva, the explanation ends, and finally is given the description of the phalam also. This result, that which was attained by Indra, don't think it can be attained by him only. The Shruti says, anybody who even today, in the present day time person also, with his limited lifetime, even though 101 years of what Indra has experienced is equal to of years how much? Because of year 1 year is 1 day of him. Of your 1 year is 1 day of him, of the deity. And in the view of 101 years, we told in the, what his ayu 100 years, this told for Manushya. In the Manushya's 101 years, in the means what? It is 101 days of Indra. That means it was only 101 days in Brahmacharya, in front of Prajapati. And we here, even after 101 births also, will not be able to catch what Indra has experienced. That's the difference. But still he says, if a person actually, with all dedication, listens to the master through the scriptures, surely he also can attain what is stated over here, but what was attained by Indra, etc. This is what Prajapati wanted to say, and he has said. This is the Shruti, and so concludes this present context regarding the Atmavidya. Bhashan. Yasmad esha Indraya Prajapatina Ukta. Since this self was spoken of by Prajapati to Indra. Therefore, Atma, Tasma, Esha Atma, Esmal, Esha Atma, Prajapatina Indraya Ukta. Since this self was spoken of by Prajapati to Indra, Tasma, therefore, Tatha Shrutva, having heard of that self from Prajapati, Tam Atmanam Adhyatvepi Deva Upasate, the gods adore and meditate on it even today. That is why they are enjoying all the luxuries. Tadupasanacha. And from the meditation of that, sarvecha loka attaha, all the worlds have been attained by them, and all the desirable things, sarvecha kamaha, teshamane, they have been attained by them. Devaha. Yadartam hi. Indra, ekashatam varshani prajapata brahmacharya uvasa, tat phalam praptam devair sarvair ityabhipraya. Even though only Indra had gone there and been following celibacy, but when he came and gave that instructions to all the deities, therefore even today, all the deities are enjoying this and maintaining that self. Yadartham hi Indra, ekashatam varshani prajapata. The idea implied is that Itavipraya means the idea implied is that the result of that very purpose for which Indra was in celibacy for 101 years in the house of Prajapati. Yadartham Prajapatau Brahmacharyam Uvasa. Indra एकशतम वर्षाणि तत्फलम प्राप्तम देवैहि इति उक्ता. दैट रिजल्ट दैट फलम फॉर विच इंद्र लिव्ड इन सेलिबेसी फॉर 101 इयर्स विद प्रजापति वाज अचीव्ड बाय ऑल अदर डेटीज टू. व्हेन दैट इज सो व्हाई नॉट टुडे. एनी पर्सन कैन अटेन इट. डिपेंड्स अपॉन द डेडिकेशन. 101 इयर्स that shows the dedication of Indra for the particular knowledge. Similarly, it depends on the dedication of the person even today. Then Bhashyakara says here again, you see, tad yuktam devanam, there's an objection. Tad yuktam devanam mahabhagyatvat natu idani manushyanam alpa jivitvat mandudar pragyatvat cha sambhavati iti prapte idam uchyate. A doubt may arise like this, that was possible for the gods because of their great fortune. They are all Mahabhagyashali Purushas, most fortunate people. Therefore, that for them it was possible, not for these human beings. How are these pitiable human beings? Idani manushyanam. And it is not possible nowadays for these present human beings who have what? The alpa jivitva. For the present times whose lives are very, very short. Not only lives are short, whatever their intellect, so hopeless. Mandatara pragyatvacha. Manda pragyana. Bhashir mandatara pragyatvacha. Whose intellects are very, very poor. Poorer than the poor. Therefore, it's not possible at all. The doubt arises. Iti prapte, when this doubt has arisen, this has been stated. Idam uchyate by Shruti. So, sarvasya lokana apnoti, sarvasya kama idanim tano api. He attains all worlds and all desirable things, even that, all that result of attaining all the worlds and all the desirable things can be attained even today by the present day person. Idanim tana tano api. Idanim means present time. Idanim tana means a person of the present time also. A person of the present time also can attain all those words and all the desirable things. Also, how is this statement told? Again, the doctor says, how is this possible? Who is that man in this world who can attain all these things? Whose capacity is so much? He says, even you can be the doubter. He says, Indradivat yastam atmanam anuvitya vijanadi. Anyone who like Indra, being totally dedicated, and other deities, realizes self after knowing it from the teacher, etc. Itya samanyena kila prajapati vacha. This is what Prajapati has said in general way. Atha सर्वेषां आत्मज्ञानं तत्फल प्राप्तिः तुल्या एव भवति. Therefore, the meaning is that the knowledge of the self and the result of that particular knowledge can be attained by one and all equal, without any difference. तुल्या एव भवति. दिर्वचनं प्रकरण समाप्त्यर्थम्. And the repetition of प्रजापतिर्वाच is to indicate the conclusion of the present topic. Now there are certain mantras will be coming for japa and homa, etc. Okay, because those who feel that living a life, I am not able to experience my universal form, and all the time I feel I am an individual person only, then he has to pray to do japa. After death at least, let me attain that. For that purpose, certain mantras will be given over here.